إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. عباد الله، اعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعاذني الله وإياكم من النار. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. ثم أما بعد، all praise is due to Allah, whom we seek His help, we seek His forgiveness, we seek refuge in Allah from whatever evil our heart conceal and from the consequences of our evil deeds. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant guidance, none can misguide him. And whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguide, none to guide. And I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his slave, servant and messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in his book, O you who believe, fear Allah as he deserves to be feared, and die not except in a status of Islam. In a status of submission, submission to one God, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, before I start my khutbah, I would like to ask a question. Would you like to go to the Jannah? Would you like to go to the Jannah? Insha'Allah. No doubt. What if I would like to discuss with you in this khutbah certain thing that if we adapt that certain things, if we do that certain things in our life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for sure, bi'idhnihi ta'ala, will take us to the Jannah. What if I tell you there are only 70 things, there are only 70 things that if you adapt, if you do, if you apply these things in your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you Jannah. Will you do that?
Sure.
Will you do that?
Sure.
Insha'Allah, alhamdulillah. 70 things compared with the Jannah, I think it's nothing. But what if I tell you there are not 70 things, there are 50 things. 50 things that you will do, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you to the Jannah. Will you do it? Insha'Allah. But what if I tell you there are only 20 things that if you will do, if you will apply in your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you to the Jannah. Will you do it? 20. What if I tell you there are only 10 things that if you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you to the Jannah. Bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. But not any Jannah. I'm talking about Jannah al-Firdaus. Al-A'la, the most highest Jannah. The most highest rank that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for who? Al-Nabiyyin, wa-Siddiqiyyin, wa-Shuhada. That's imagine that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His will take you to the Jannah, Jannah al-Firdaus, by doing these certain things, you will be with companion. You will be with ash-shuhada, the martyrs. You will be with the prophets. And overall, you will be with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Will you do that? Insha'Allah. But the good and glad tidy and good news is there are only 7 things. Up to 70 till 7. Only 7 things if you do and if you apply in your life, if you adopt these things, Allah, subhanAllah, He will take you to the Jannah. Jannah al-Firdaus, عرضها السماوات والأرض. That Jannah is bigger than the heaven and the earth. So my brothers and sisters, number one, memorize them. Open your mind and memorize them. Number one is al-Iman. That you have to have Iman. That you have to be a believer, a true believer. And as we know, Iman have six pillars in Islam. أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره. That we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no doubt. We believe in the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe in all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We believe in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he revealed to all his prophets. And we believe as well in the day of judgment. And we believe in Al-Qadr, the divine, the predestination that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala written upon us. But here's a little fault that we fall in. We know that everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that, alhamdulillah. But what happened with us, when something good is happening to us, we say alhamdulillah. When you get increment in your job, alhamdulillah, in your salary, you say alhamdulillah. When you get a good job, you say alhamdulillah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with a child, you will say alhamdulillah. Anything good happened to you, you say alhamdulillah. Just one thing if goes wrong, why Allah? Why this happening to me? In the entire world, why Allah chose me? And this is the most dangerous status, my brothers and sisters. Our iman, our faith in qadar khayrihi wa sharrihi. That you believe in the qadar, either it's good or bad. This is our faith. This is our belief. So, number one is al-iman. You have to have a strong belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, my brothers and sister, al-khushu'i wal-khudu'i fi salah. That your salah should be humble. You pray calmly, with humble, with sincere. This is called al-khushu' wal-khudu'i fi salah. This is second category or second thing that you have to do in your life to attain Jannah. Iman and al-khushu' wal-khudu'i fi salah. It's not only that you stand very calmly and then you go to ruku' very calmly and then you come back very calmly. This is one of the things, but beside it, al-khushu' comes when you know what you are saying. When you say Allahu Akbar, you know that Allah is the greatest than everything. Once you submit yourself to Allah, when you put your hands up, khalas, surrender. Imagine. And this is exactly the way when someone take gun and point off you, what you will do, the first thing is like this, right? That means if he tell you sit, you will sit. Move, move. Go, go. Same thing. Once you do like that you're totally submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what should we know in our salah. When you say Allahu Akbar, Allah is greatest from my job. Allah is the greatest from my family. Allah is the greatest from everything that I'm doing, my business, whatever. Allah is the greatest. When you say Sami Allahu liman hamida, you know what that mean. When you say Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, you should know what that mean. And if you don't know, you better read about it to attain that Jannah. عرضها السماوات والأرض. This is number two, my brothers and sister. Number three, الإعراضي عن اللغو في الكلام, which means to avoid unnecessary talk, to avoid unnecessary speech, impious speech, impious talk, vain talk that will not benefit you either in this dunya or akhirah. Just get rid of it. This is in Quran, it said al-laghu. Subhanallah, companion and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after salat al-isha, they don't talk to each other as much as possible. Or the minimum things that they can communicate with. So this is, if you know that you are sitting in a gathering, and unfortunately in our society, we start our gathering after Salat al-Isha. We start our diwaniya after Salat al-Isha. Yes, in this gathering, If it's dhikr, if it's Quran, if it's Allah and Rasul mentioned, that's alhamdulillah fine. But majority what happened in our gathering is al-qila wal-qal. Well, this person did that, and this person went through this and that, and just we talk worldly things that will not gonna benefit us in this dunya and al-akhirah. That's called al-laghu, and we should minimum or just avoid al-laghu as much as we can, my brothers and sisters. Number four, al-zakah, paying your zakat. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with a job, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with income on monthly basis, on yearly basis, with bonus or whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you, that you have to give the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by paying only 2.5 from your money, which is zakat, to the poor people. Is it hard? Never. Never. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. So we mentioned three. The fourth is paying your zakat to those who need it. Number five, my brothers and sisters, حِفْظُ الْفَرْجِ. And this is serious matter at this time. حِفْظُ الْفَرْجِ is protecting your private parts. We are living in a time, my brothers and sisters, that subhanAllah, nudity everywhere. People are naked, almost naked at the markets. If you go by yourself or with your family, you don't know where to go. تعري, naked people, nudity, no hijab, no concept of modesty, everything is vanishing. And by that, big possibility that a person fall into fitna. And he cannot protect his private parts. This is one of the term, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that, one of the term to attain Jannat al-Firdaus is saving our private parts, except to our spouse. So this is the category number five. Number six, my brothers and sisters, al-amana. And this is another topic. We can talk about al-amana in many, many khutbas. But in general, amana means trust. So you have to be trustworthy towards whatever you have as a trust. It doesn't mean only, my brothers and sisters, if someone give you something to keep it with you, something valuable, money or anything, or jewelry, you keep it with you, and after some time that person will come and you will give it back to him. This is just one category of al-amana that we know. Amana at your work, that you have to be trustworthy at your work. Amana in your school. Amana with your family, amana with your children, amana with everything. And many people fall into the first category that I mentioned, amana at work. If work, your work telling you that you have to come for 8 hours and work, you cannot go half an hour late and leave half an hour early. This is called al-khiyana fil amana, that you are not trustworthy for what you are doing. Some people take it very lightly. If you have to leave at 3 or 4, they leave at 2. No one is here, no work. You punch your finger or you leave without anything. This is khiyana, this is not amana. As well, those who go to work and they make... You know, it's very deep, my brother and sister, subhanAllah. That's why I'm saying it's a very long topic. But for example, those who go to their work and use the photocopy machine for their private use. Not allowed, this is not amana, this is khiyana. If one of the companies, or if the company gives you a car and mobile for work purpose only, you cannot use it for personal use. That let me go and pick my son, let me go and go to the market and buy something. La. This is khiyana. This is very deep issue and very critical issue that you have to be. Wallahi, I know someone. Because it's very sensitive, even you cannot use the pen that work provides you at work, that you write something personal. I know someone, wallahi, he have his own ball pen in his pocket and he have his own notebook on his desk. He bought and he said, whenever I have something, I use my mobile and I use that pen, even though I don't want ink of the other pen that I'm trustworthy for to write anything against me in the Day of Judgment. Imagine, ink. He cannot write only 7 digits number for someone. He said, la wallahi, I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That much. And we can go more and more. But we have to be trustworthy people in our life, not at work, but in everywhere. Number 7, my brothers and sisters, is the last. المحافظة على الصلاة. الصلاة. The prayer. Observing the prayers. It's easy for those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made easy for them, and sometimes it's very hard for those, may Allah have mercy on them, they cannot do it on time or properly. But these 7 categories and these 7 things, once you adopt in your life, believe me, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, your way to paradise, Jannat al-Firdaus, is easy. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. So there are only 7, and I would like to remind you again. Al-Iman, that you have to have belief not in Allah, but in everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to believe in. Number 2, الخشوع والخضوع في الصلاة, that your prayer should be, you do it humbly, sincerely, and calmly, with understanding the meaning of each thing that you are saying. Not necessary that you have to understand the meaning of the ayat that you are reciting, that you can come later on. Yes, this is also one of the necessity. But at least what you're saying is Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, or Subhanallah al-Azim, or Sami'allahu liman hamida, and the one who you are standing in front of, these things you have to keep in your mind. Number 3 is al-i'radi an al-laghu. Avoid the unnecessary talk that will not benefit you in this dunya or al-akhirah. Either it's in a gathering with friends, or either it's at home with your wife. If you think it's not necessary to talk about, be quiet. If you think by mentioning someone, your wife start cursing him, then it's better to be quiet. If you know by mentioning some kind of incident, your wife or your brother or your mother will be get angry or something like that, and it's not use or no use for it, be quiet. This is called avoiding al-laghu. Number four is al-zakat. Number 5, protecting your private guards, guarding your private parts. Number 6, al-amana, being trustworthy. Number 7, praying on time. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. If you are doing it, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you on this track. And somehow if you are missing these prayers, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you and give you tawfiq to pray these prayers on time, inshaAllah. أقول ما تسمعون أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. اللهم إني أستغفرك. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على نبيه المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجهم واقتدى وعلى أثرهم اكتفى. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, as we know and as we believe that in Islam, whatever we follow, whatever we do, whatever we act upon should be coming from 2 sources, Quran and Hadith. So whatever you listen, whatever you hear about Jannah and Akhirah and reward and this and that, you have to be certainly know, or you have to get to know that these things coming from the Quran versus from Quran or from the authentic hadith. So what I mentioned today, the 7 things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by doing that, will take you to the Jannah al-Firdaus bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, it's from Surah Al-Mu'minun, chapter number 23. Verse number from 1 till 11. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, successful indeed are the believers. Number 1. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those who are submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their prayers. Number 2. خُشُوعُ. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. Those who avoid impious talk. Those who avoid vain talk. Another category. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. And those who pay the zakat on time regularly. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ.
and those who guard their private parts. And ayah goes until وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. And those who are keepers of their trust and their covenant. Another category. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And those who are observed for or to their prayers. Seven categories. But what after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. Those are the inheritors. Inheritors of what? الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Those who will inherit الفردوس الأعلى, and they shall live forever into it. Allahu Akbar. By doing only seven things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. Indeed, they are the inheritors of the paradise. جَنَّةِ الْفِرْدَوْسِ الْأَعْلَى هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They will live into that Jannah forever. Eternal life. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our path easy for us so we can follow and adopt all these things that we mentioned. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to follow the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma arfa' kalimat al-haq wa rayat al-din. Allahumma thabbit al-muwahideen. Alladhina يجاهدون لإعلاء كلمة لا إله إلا الله. اللهم عليك بالظالمين. اللهم عليك بمن يشوه صورة الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم عليك بمن يشوه صورة الإسلام والمسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا قوي يا قهار, سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين, وأقم الصلاة.